Well, then let's rock and roll. Hello, hello, and welcome to the Rock Metal Podcast. I am your host, John Harris. Today on the Rock Metal Podcast, we have Warside, and they have a new six-track EP called The Enemy Inside, which is released at the end of 2020, December 12th. And right now I'm being joined by Vincent. Is that correct, yes. Vincent?
Yes, exactly. Everybody, hello.
Hello. Beautiful. So, Vincent, how is life? You're in Lyon, correct?
Yes, I live in Lyon, in France.
Beautiful.
And life is a bit difficult with the current situations.
I bet. Now, I went to culinary school, so Lyon is like, you know, the place of magic, as far as I understand, because of the culinary the culinary scene. How is the culinary scene now in Lyon? Are restaurants allowed to be open? How is things going?
Yes, everything is closed in Lyon. Life is completely stopped. We only are able, allowed to work, and that's all.
Okay. Terrible.
Yes, like in France, yes.
Wow. Okay. Now, when it comes to this record, the six-track EP, I guess my first question is, why a six-track EP? You guys could have had like a full album with like one more song.
yes. Good question. How we have thought our music due to the COVID-19 in France. The question was, were we ready to prepare a full album, knowing that we won't have any tools or any moment to make concert or not? And it's the main reason that's why we have decided to release a six-track EP. And the album, we are starting working on a new album, and we will have to wait a few months to be listening to our new songs. Yes.
Yeah, cool. So this EP then, did you guys do all of the recording in 2020 during lockdown?
Yes, exactly, in the summer last year.
Okay. What was that like recording during lockdown? Was it actually pretty easy to do, or was it difficult?
It was a different organization because in France, I don't know how it works in the other countries with, once again, the COVID-19, but in France, we were allowed to work and to do what we wanted to do during the day. And we have organized our days to be able to record during the day and not the night, for example.
Okay.
So we have to take some vacations with our jobs to have enough time to record our album.
Wow. That must have been interesting, taking vacation time to work.
Yes, yes, precious time. But for our death metal, we are ready above all.
Exactly. Now,
yes.
Were you guys planning to make a record anyway, or is this The Enemy Inside? Is this in response to the lockdown situation?
No, we started writing this EP with the guys before the lockdown and before the illness, and we were ready to record our six track during this summer, which doesn't stop, and which even if we only release the six track EP, we are already working on the new album. So it's for us. It's two different things, and we are impatient to know the feedback on people regarding our music. Yes, maybe to imagine their point of view, how they feel when they hear our music. So yes, it depends. We will see, but we won't stop. That's sure.
Mm-hmm. Now, there's also a music video here for Hero Shed No Tears. Now, I imagine that was something similar to the studio time. Did you guys have to take vacation time to film the music video?
Yes. Fortunately, for this video, we only had to work 2 days for the two video clips. So it wasn't a big effort for us regarding our jobs.
Okay. So then Feeding the Crows looks like the other music video.
Yes.
Did you guys film them at the same time?
No. Okay. 1 month later, yes.
Okay. Very cool. Now, Heroes Shed No Tears. Take us through this track. What is this track about? What does that mean, Heroes Shed No Tears?
I see. This song is linked with the Second World War, and just to give you a small summary, it's the story of a soldier during the landing in Normandy on Omaha Beach, mm-hmm. and this guy were so afraid that was so afraid, sorry, that he spent his time completely hidden and spent his time seeing his friend killed. Sorry. After this war, he comes back home, welcomed as a hero, whereas he was a coward, a traitor with his friend, with his teams, and this song explains how he feels inside his head, hearing the voice of his dead friends and becoming completely crazy day after day. So yeah. It's a big line of this morceau, of this song, sorry.
Yeah, no, that's a really deep topic, Vincent.
Yes, yes, pretty. Our singer is very inspired when he writes his lyrics.
Mm-hmm. Now, is that just for one song, or is that a concept to the whole EP?
I think we can speak about war in general for the whole EP. Violence, wars, anger, aggressivity, and it's a global topic for our EP. It's the way we feel in this current world regarding the behaviors of people everywhere in the world. Yes, all these things inspire our music.
Yeah.
If I was correctly understood your question.
Yes. Yes, you did. But yeah, the interesting thing is that topic, obviously, for anybody who had a grandfather who was in World War II, and I know my grandfather was in World War II, that kind of idea of something to grapple with, that one of the things they might actually be grappling with is, if only I could right that wrong, if only I could go back and have done something more, is quite the gripping, I don't know if you want to call that a fear or whatever, but as you put it, instead of actually being a hero like they're lauded as, that they, in their mind anyway, aren't. It's a deep topic.
Yes, yes, and we don't judge anything. We don't say our grandparents attended this war too, with the guy in the band. Yeah. So we are directly concerned by this topic. We don't say what is good, what is bad. We are not here and not enough skilled to give any opinion. It's just a story to describe how people can feel in a specific environment, and the specific environment regarding the general topic of our EP is the Second World War.
Yeah, well, I mean, Normandy would obviously be very close to home for you guys, I believe.
Sorry?
Normandy would be very close to home for you guys, I believe.
Yes, we don't speak about any nationality or any country. It's just a story.
Right.
Yes, we don't. Once again, we don't say what is good, what is bad, or anything. It's just the story of a guy who went completely crazy due to unappropriated behavior.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Absolutely. Now, something else that you mentioned was the feedback from people. Now, at the time of chatting about this, the record's been available for about a month, maybe a little bit longer at the time of us chatting. How has the reaction been so far?
Yes, we have pretty very good feedback. Our blast beat is a specific way to yes, to speak with eight bangers, and yes, I think our music is extreme enough to be able to be understood by some extreme guys who loves extreme music. So globally, we had very good feedbacks from other countries in all around the world, Asia, America, each from each zone in this world, and in France too, because we have. Even if the band has is 2 years ago, has been founded 2 years ago, we are all guys from the metal scene and the metal environment in Lyon. So we have a very nice network, which allows us to have some feedbacks and honest feedback, not only by friends. So the first point of view regarding the feedbacks is very positive for us.
That's good. Now you mentioned the scene in Lyon. Is it a big metal scene in Lyon?
It depends the point of view. Yes, because there are not a lot of blast beat bands, but there are lots of existing bands in different styles. We can find black metal, thrash metal, death metal. Every styles are represented in Lyon, and I think yes, the scene is quite strong. It's quite strong and very friendly.
Okay, cool.
Yes.
Now you know the funny thing, Vincent, is when I got the information from Against PR, and it said, you know, for fans of Aborted, Misery Index, Vomitory. The first thing I thought of was Christian Kuhle, the German producer who produces a lot of death metal bands and technical death metal bands. Kind of just a strange question. Is he somebody that you guys would like to work with, or are there any producers in particular that you'd like to work with to really take the sound to the next level?
We are open. We are very open. Even if we have lots of friends, lots of contact among the musicians, we have no big network with producers and all the other kinds of companies working directly with our kind of music. So it's hard for me to give you a precise answer.
Yeah. Now, something you did mention, though, speaking of production, was you guys are working on a new album. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. What can you tell us about this new album? Is it something we should be expecting in 2021?
It's very hard to foresee anything in France with the current situation. As we told, as we spoke, with the COVID-19, everything is closed. Sometimes it's a complete lockdown. Sometimes it's a half lockdown. So sometimes recorded studios are open. Sometimes they are cold. It's very hard to organize and to foresee anything. The only one thing which is sure is that we have already started writing new songs, and we already are working on new stuff.
Okay.
And it won't be less aggressive than the first EP. No. It's sure.
Yeah. Is there a theme? Is it going to be war themed as well, or is lyrics not been written yet?
I think we will keep the same direction regarding the global theme. Sorry. Yes.
Yeah. Cool. And then similar production team. I mean, I know you said it's kind of difficult. I'm seeing here you guys recorded at Convol Sound.
Yes, Common Sound Studio is managed by a friend, Thibaut Bernard, and his guy has recorded lots of bands in France, and he has a very good experience and very good skills to improve our music when it's recorded. Okay. So he's a very good guy, very skilled, and it's possible that we go on working with him.
Okay, very cool.
Only future will say, will inform us, yes.
Yeah, fantastic. And you guys have been safe? Nobody's gotten COVID?
No, everything is fine. So, yes, perfect. And we can't claim about this, yes.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so, Vincent, we've chatted about the EP. We've chatted about the upcoming work. We've chatted about Heroes Shed No Tears. There's music video available for it, and that'll be posted in today's show notes.
Thank you.
Yeah. Cool music video. Did you guys have an idea for what you wanted to do for the music video before you filmed it?
It was our first music videos, and so we just wanted to record something simple and easy. We are not skilled enough to make a big story, a big film with a complicated scenario. We only wanted to show the violence of our music through this video. And for us, what we love watching is the guy playing their instruments, and that's why we wanted to show the same thing, only guys playing their instruments, playing their music, and depending the environment, in nature, outside or inside, just easy and simple clear music videos.
Okay, cool. And then we kind of chatted about 2021 plans. It's hard to plan this year, though. But you guys are working on a record, going to record it as best as you can. Was there anything that you wanted to chat about, Vincent, that I did not bring up?
Sorry, can you repeat, please? Connectivity was a problem.
Yeah. Is there anything that I did not ask that you wanted to chat about?
The most important thing in this band is that we are a group of friends. We have special links between us, and it's our force today. It's our force, and thanks to the complicated environment, it inspires us creating and writing such aggressive music. So I think I have summed in this sentence all the warside way of thinking, and I'm sure that it won't stop tomorrow. Yes.
Plenty to be angry about, eh?
Yes, very.
Beautiful. All right. Well, Vincent, thank you so much for coming on to the Rock Metal Podcast today.
Thank you for your time, for the interview, and for your support. Really, it's very cool. It's very cool.
De rien, mon ami.
Thank you very much. And may the best feed your soul. It's our official sentence.
Okay. Very cool.